Could there be a competitor to Blackout and Fortnite? Well, it is starting to shape up like that is what is going to happen, everybody. What is up? Chaos here. This is going to be a pretty quick update video for you guys, but it is a big one. The gameplay you're watching is some traditional Black Ops original Nuketown gameplay from Born and Leo. If you guys want to submit your gameplay for a chance to be on the channel, link is in the description. I also dropped a huge giveaway. I'm giving away 20 battle passes when Season 8 launches in Fortnite. That is also in the description, and a bonus entry if you go over to my Twitter. So good luck, everybody. Now, let's talk about the rumors that are floating around, and they are starting to hold, they're starting to look real. I'm talking about Titanfall and EA supposedly dropping a bomb next week in the form of a Titanfall Battle Royale game. Now you may say, this is fake. EA hasn't promoted this. There's no marketing campaign behind it. There's no teasers. There's no nothing. Well, that is exactly the case. It looks like they are going to drop this on everybody with absolutely nothing. Maybe a teaser today. I don't know. And it actually, it's kind of smart, because it's completely different from anything EA has ever done, and it is getting people's attention. So, Jeremy Hambley, the host of the gaming commentary channel The Quartering, broke the story where he said he had a credible insider that had inside information about the game. According to him, the publishers at EA will be announcing the game on Monday, February 4th, which is 2 days away of the recording of this video. It is a full-fledged Battle Royale game that is going to be open to the public and free to play. You heard me right. It is supposedly going to be free to play. So here are the highlights of what he said. And once again, this is all alleged. At this moment, nothing is confirmed. The official name of the game will be Apex Legends. It is supposedly going to be part of the Titanfall series. It, of course, is being developed by Respawn Entertainment. The game is set to be announced and released at the same time on February 4th and available for play immediately. The gameplay will be a crossover between Call of Duty Blackout and Rainbow Six Siege, but it will be in a battle royale format. Teams will consist of a maximum of 3 players, with each player having a character that complements the other 2 teammates. The map size will be able to hold 60 total players, so a minimum of 20 teams. As for microtransactions, they supposedly will be in there, both purchasable for cosmetic items and in-game content, which of course they're going to have microtransactions in the game if the game is a free-to-play. But there's more to it that makes it seem like it could be real. Now, I've heard rumors about this. I talked to people, and there was a secret event that Respawn just got done with, and 2 of your biggest prominent streamers, it looks like they went, okay? Shroud and Dr. Disrespect could have been playtesting this battle royale, all right? The biggest clue that the pair had been out to playtest the game came from Twitter. Both streamers announced that they were taking the day off, which was January 31st. Shroud even confirmed it was for secret stuff in LA. You guys can see his tweet on the video here. No stream tomorrow. Heading down to LA for some super secret stuff. And then Dr. Disrespect, tomorrow all day I'll be looking so good in the arena, and you will too. Yeah. Reminder, today or tomorrow I am off. Now, it doesn't stop there. If you guys follow Slasher over on Twitter, well, he doesn't even keep it a secret. He says, Respawn invited top streamers and esports pros across Battle Royale and other FPS games to playtest Apex Legends in LA this past week. Speaking and honestly, multiple attendees said the game felt good and they were genuinely excited for it. One top BR streamer player provided their thoughts. The game definitely has a lot of potential. I don't think it'll get old fast. Was sad to leave when the time was up, and I can't really say that about new games in this gaming drought. I'm excited to see where it goes. Now, this is huge, people. No, it's not 100 people. It's 60 is what they're going off of. So 20 teams, 3 to a team, trios to a team. But if it's in the format kind of between Blackout and Rainbow Six, it's a methodical, maybe a little more fast paced, but it's in the form of a battle royale, this could be huge. And it all depends on the replayability factor of this, the fun factor, because you know, if it is fun, if it is fresh, then all the big influencers are going to put their, I kind of put their push behind it. And if they do, that is what blows games up. This has been going on for a long time. Minecraft, PUBG, Fortnite, Call of Duty, all of those. It's big influencers go and play them, and then they blow up. So if this game is any good at all, this could be the next big thing. We'll have to wait and see. I know you're a lot of you are saying Titanfall. Titanfall? What? But there's a lot of people out there that love the Titanfall experience. So I'm going to keep you guys posted. Obviously, if this comes out, I'm going to get it. I'm going to try it. I may stream it. We'll dive into it and see if it is anything. But for the people saying this is all fake, there's too much lining up right now for this to be fake. Something is going down Monday or early next week, and it looks like this is what it's going to be, a Titanfall Battle Royale free-to-play. So my question to you is, are you going to download it? Are you going to give it a try? Drop a like, guys. Hopefully you found this informative. Make sure you're subscribed. Turn on your notifications. Thank you for the Black Ops 1 gameplay, Born in Leo, and I'll see you guys soon.